This morning in the haunted kitchen, we welcome back Chef Gerry DuPont from Edible Creations by Gerry. He's got a delicious recipe on the menu today. What are we making?
Are you saying that I'm scary?
No,
Princess
but
Michaela.
We've got some scary, spooky, delicious treats, though.
True.
What are we making?
We're doing some red velvet cupcakes.
Perfect. Blood velvet cupcakes. Beautiful. What do we need?
Basic cake. It starts with 2 sticks of butter.
Mm-hmm. Softened or?
Softened.
Okay.
2 cups of sugar. And we're going to whip that later.
Okay.
All-purpose flour.
Do we need to sift that?
We're going to sift actually the flour, the cinnamon, and the baking soda.
Okay.
And salt. We're going to sift that all together.
Beautiful.
Bourbon vanilla. Got to have the bourbon.
Why not?
Red food coloring, liquid, milk, eggs, and then we have cream cheese and a little bit of shortening and butter for the frosting.
For the frosting. Yum. And you've actually, you've got a lot of different treats over there, which we will tell you about throughout the entire morning. But is this something that you love to do? I know that you do a lot of like regular cooking and stuff too. But when it comes to putting all these fun little treats, especially when they're themed, that must be really exciting.
It's awesome. Awesome. I mean, it's my passion.
Mm-hmm.
So I think you have to love what you do and follow through with it. Yeah, I really enjoy making people smile.
Yeah.
It
really shows, though. I mean, the care that you give all your treats and everything, too. And this is an easy enough recipe.
Everyone eats with their eyes. So.
Right. Exactly.
First.
And you even have some eyeballs on the cupcakes,
yeah, right.
too, which you'll see in just a minute. Okay, gather up your ingredients. We're making cupcakes today in the kitchen. It's a great day. We'll get things started when we come back.
For now, we want to send it back into the kitchen. We'll take it away, sir.
Stormtrooper Julia Childs, together again. Chef Gerry DuPont here. Edible Creations by Gerry. We got red velvet cake with some vanilla cream cheese frosting on the menu today.
You're not going to shoot me, are you?
No, I'm not going to shoot you. No, no, I can barely move. Let's put it that way. All right, what do we need to do right now, Gerry?
I can't stay in character.
Oh, no.
We're actually going to start with the butter.
Mm-hmm.
And
is that for the frosting or is that
for the cake?
For the cake itself.
Okay. Start with 2 sticks of butter and 2 cups of granulated sugar.
Okay.
And you're going to whip it until it's light and fluffy.
Yep.
That's your basic ingredients for the start of any cake mix, pretty much.
What is the secret? Because sometimes a lot of people, they love red velvet cake, but sometimes red velvet cake doesn't seem to be as moist as other cakes, other cakes do.
You don't want to whip it at the final stage. You don't want to whip it too long.
Okay.
You want to whip it until it's just incorporated. Take it off the mixer and then continue the mixer by hand.
Got it. Okay. All right. So that'll mix for a little bit. Put that together.
So basically, we're going to sift the flour.
Mm-hmm. And why are you doing that? Is that just to break up all of the, like if there's any lumps in it or anything?
Well, you want everything to be totally combined.
Okay.
Especially the baking powder and the salt.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just going to mix this.
And that's, put that all together there.
Yep.
Looks good. And then you got to drop in a couple of...
Normally we would mix this until it's a little more fluffy, but we're going to add the eggs.
Okay.
One at a time.
Yep. Goes in, you get like 4 eggs for that.
Slow it down a little bit so it's not all over the place.
And then what else are you going to make it?
Milk.
Milk and...
The red food coloring.
Red food coloring.
If you like Elvis, you can do blue.
Sounds good. All right, so we're going to put this together. We'll talk to Gerry about what's going on.
And try Julia Childs.
And Julia Childs, try a little of this red velvet cake. Back to you.
We are back in the Star Wars kitchen. Who knew Leia and Darth Vader could cook? Well, we can bake at least, because Chef Gerry DuPont is here from Edible Creations by Gerry. Actually, well, Gerry had to step away earlier.
Yes. He's a very busy boy.
Julia.
It's like mother and daughter cooking with Vader and Leia. Here we go.
All right. Where do we stand?
Are you going to give me some
here we
power
go.
Here?
I'm going to use the force to turn on the blender. Here we go. Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
Wow. That's a lot of force.
Thank you.
What are we actually making cream cheese frosting.
Great.
You start with 1 8-ounce package of cream cheese, 1 stick of butter,
mm-hmm.
unsalted. A little bit of shortening for stabilize, and 2 pounds of 6X sugar, and of course the bourbon vanilla.
Yep.
I have my wine.
You may have your wine in the Julia voice.
Yes.
There you are. Yes. Very nice.
Thank
Pass
you,
on
darling.
Down there.
God, it's awful. Basically, cream cheese lends very well to red velvet.
Yeah, we see
Perfect.
That combination a lot.
And carrot cake, of course.
Sure. I can't wait to sample.
Did you get to check out the gingerbread skeleton?
Very nice. These are so cute, and they're easy to make. If you have a little gingerbread cookie cutter at home, maybe you left it there from the holidays, just some simple, just regular icing. You could even do store-bought if you don't feel like making
regular
it.
Regular icing, that's actually royal icing, which is made with meringue powder and 6X sugar.
Very nice.
Oh, look at that, just a couple quick lines, dots. It really adds to it.
And being that it is Halloween.
Wow.
Walk off with his head.
You savage. You're savage. You
okay, so we've got a pastry bag here. I'm going to fill that up with some of the frosting.
You want to make some ghosts?
We've seen a lot of... A lot of tips, too, that you could always do just a Ziploc bag, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
We'll have one of those, yep.
I love this tip because it's so versatile.
Mm-hmm. Just basic if there's no star shape to it.
Use it for borders if you want.
Wow.
But this is...
One-handed. Man.
Our ghost.
Beautiful. Okay, so we're making a ghost. We have chocolate cupcakes and we have red velvet. I don't know if
Not very often you get to work in a kitchen with a princess.
And a dark lord.
And a dark lord.
I tried to do it one-handed like you.
Very
that was a lot of frosting.
I'm going to go two hands.
Okay.
I'm going to go two hands.
You might need a little more frosting in there. But this is so fun. We were talking about carving pumpkins and going out trick-or-treating. I mean, this is another fun activity that you can do this weekend if you really don't feel like going out.
These are great to make with the kids tonight, even.
I hope
if you're not going out trick-or-treating.
I hope the Emperor doesn't tune in and see me in this roadshow apron. It could be an awkward management meeting. Performance
nice
review.
Thank you.
Well, we got a lot of stuff hiding behind that frame to decorate.
Oh, to decorate away. Beautiful.
Eyeballs and spray and gold glitter.
Edible spray. We've got a lot of fun little treats, little rings and stuff.
Eyeballs. You know, Michaela used up most of the icing. However, I will say, Gerry.
There you go.
Well, I will say this. Some people only like a little bit on there, so.
This is true.
Yeah, I'm just saying, just a little dab of icing.
It's very,
there you are.
Picasso. But they might want a little bit more than
just
that.
But there are options.
Okay, I'm going to decorate mine. I like this orange spray. This is really cool.
Yeah.
How far away should I hold this?
The closer you are, the more intense it's going to be.
Okay.
Oh, very nice.
Just the dusting.
Inhale. Oh, that looks awesome, though.
Inhale, you get the vapors of sugar.
Oh, it does smell like sugar.
Isn't that great?
Oh, yeah.
Yum.
We're all going to get high in the roadshow
kitchen. Very cool.
Oh, no.
This is awesome.
And done? Last but not least, all right, there we go.
I'm going to sneak around and get some sprinkles.
Using the force
now,
to
Gerry,
squeeze
it. Now, Gerry, do you sell a lot of cupcakes?
Yes. We our little Compton store actually is probably the busiest location that we have. Montauk is kind of slowing down now because golf season is pretty much wrapping up here in New England. Which is actually welcomed. We're going to take a little break for now until Thanksgiving comes.
Yeah, everyone needs a good little break.
Absolutely.
But plenty of treats that they can get at your shop.
Absolutely.
Like you said.
You clear those cannolis.
Perfect.
Thanks, man.
You bet. Thank you, ma'am.
Man.
Spiders on
here. Some decorations really complete the whole thing. This, Gerry, is the quintessential Halloween activity, something to do with
this
the kids.
So
the whole family can get involved.
Right.
All right, well, I'm going to let the two of you continue to decorate away. I'm double caped, apron and regular cape. Thanks, buddy. Gerry, we appreciate it.
Thanks, man.
Nice work, Leia. All right, if you would like more information on edible creations by Gerry or to learn how to do these cupcakes, she's keeping a cupcake eye on you. You know what to do. Just head to our website, roadshow.com.